Welcome to 51.4, where we will be looking at some cell signaling questions that come very frequently in your Cambridge examinations, and what is a pattern of answer which is the most mark fetching for this topic. So before we start looking at the questions, I wanted to quickly recap our understanding on what is the meaning of the term cell signaling. So we know that cells are constantly communicating with the neighboring cells as well as chemicals in their environment. So this behavior of cells to send and receive information from their neighboring cells and to interact with the chemicals in their environment is called cell signaling. While studying the theory about cell signaling, we had come across three different types of cell signaling. The first one being autocrine signaling, where the signal molecules are released by the cell and the signal molecules target is the same cell. So basically the cell which is producing the signaling molecule is the target itself. What is the meaning of target? The meaning of target over here is once the signal which carries the message binds to the receptor, it sends a message to the cell. And what does the cell do with that message? It performs a particular response or a function. So in case of autocrine signaling, the same cell which produces the signal will also get stimulated or will get triggered to produce a certain thing like a protein or an enzyme, and that is the cellular response. The second type of cell signaling is paracrine signaling, where cells in a local distance, that is in a small region, cells belonging to the same tissues or cells belonging to neighboring tissues interact or communicate with each other by one cell becoming a sender and the other cell being the target. So on our screen over here, the pink colored cell is producing the signaling molecule. So this is a sender, and the green circles represent the signal molecule, which is binding to the receptors on the target cell. Please make sure that you use the vocabulary that I am using, the sender and the target. The target cell always contains the receptors, and the receptor has to be complementary to the shape of the chemical signals or the ligands. If they are not complementary, then the signal sent by this cell will not be received by the target cell. So when the signal molecules have to travel a short distance to reach the target, that kind of cell-to-cell communication is called paracrine signaling. The third type is the endocrine signaling, where the signal molecules are produced at a distance, but they reach the target through bloodstream. That is, they enter the blood vessel and they exit the blood vessel to reach the target cell or the target tissue or target organ, whatever you can say. So from this slide, we get to learn that the basic structure of cell signaling is, it includes three main components. One is the signal molecule, one is the receptor, and one is the target cell. So the signal molecule is produced in one cell. Sometimes the signal molecule will trigger the effect on the same cell, that is the sender and the target is the same cell, which is your autocrine, or the sender is very closely located to the target cell, or they are far apart from each other, the sender and the target, and the chemical signaling molecule travels through the bloodstream to reach the target cell. This is endocrine signaling. Okay, now that we recapped three different types of cell-to-cell signaling, one more thing you need to always keep on your fingertips are these points. In all of your cell signaling questions, there has to be one question where a context will be given and you will be asked how this is an example of cell signaling. So they will give you a certain scenario and they may ask you, explain how this scenario is a cell signaling process going on. So to explain all of that, you have to first identify What is your signaling molecule in the question, or what is the ligand? Second thing you have to identify is what is the target cell in this story or in this case study. Okay. After identifying the target cell, you need to immediately mention that the target cell is a cell which will have the receptors. Okay. If you mention that, you get another mark for that. So you say that the receptors are on the target cell and they are, why are they there? They are there to receive the ligands or the chemical signals. Then the fourth marking point is always around candidate clearly stating that the receptor has to be complementary to the ligand. Otherwise, the target cell is not that ligand's target cell. If your target cell is responding when the ligand is binding to the receptor, that means the ligand and the receptor are complementary to each other. Okay, so you have to mention that in your answer. And finally, the second last point is activation. So what happens when the ligand and the receptor complementarily bind? They will activate neighboring enzymes in the membrane. And what will this activation of enzyme do? Activation of this enzyme will actually start a chain of reaction, which we call a cascade. So if one reaction is initiated, that will lead to initiation of three other, and those three will individually initiate three more reactions of their own. So a series of amplified reactions will begin, and some of those reactions involve activation of another messenger. This use of this term is also very mark fetching, that is second messenger. Most of the time, the second messengers in a cell are actually the CAMP or cyclic adenosine monophosphate. So you have to talk about the second messenger. So if this is the second messenger, what is our first messenger then? Our first messenger is nothing but this receptor which receives the signal from the ligand. So our first message that came was actually accepted by the receptor on the cell membrane. This receptor activated a number of enzymes which produced a second messenger. Now this is like a relay race. Now the second messenger will start activating other important enzymes, and finally, why is this process happening? There is a final outcome. The final outcome is always the cellular response. That is, after all of this stimulation and triggering, what is the cell going to do with this message? It's going to perform a certain function. Most of them, this function is either activation of a gene, which will now express a particular type of protein, or the gene codes for a certain protein in your nucleus, but that gene is switched off. When the ligand binds to the receptor and a series of reaction happens, second messenger activates the other molecules in your cytoplasm, and this is actually the signal transduction pathway, and that will activate your DNA to produce a certain type of protein needed for some cell function. So the last important point in your answer should always be a cellular response. So here on screen, your question is on the left hand side. It says production of milk by the cells of mammary glands involve action of several enzymes, different enzymes. The cell surface membrane of these cells contain the membrane protein PRLR, figure 5.1. This is your figure 5.1. And it shows an outline summary of HPRL involvement in production of breast milk. Okay. Explain why the production of breast milk can be described as an example of cell signaling process, and it is 4 marks. So when I looked at this question, the first thing that I noticed was here there are some cells in the brain which are releasing some chemical molecules, and they are entering this blood capillary, traveling all the way into the blood, and then reaching cells in the mammary gland, binding to this membrane protein PRLR over here. And when they bind, something is happening inside the cytoplasm of these mammary cells, which is leading to production of milk. So So first thing that occurs in my mind is production of breast milk is the cellular response in this whole event that is happening. And these are my sender cells. So these cells are actually making the signal molecule. So here I'll get my first mark where I refer or I give direct identification of the signaling molecule, that is the HPRL molecule, because I am seeing it traveling through the blood and reaching another set of cell. So the second thing that I will add in my answer is, who is my target receptor? So PRLR is the receptor. Third, I get my third mark for recognizing the target cell. So I identified the mammary gland cells as the target cells. I identified the membrane protein PRLR as the receptor. I identified HPRL as my ligand or signaling molecule. And finally, I will say that after the ligand and the receptor complementarily bind with each other, they initiate a cascade of reaction which will activate many enzymes in the cytoplasm of these mammary gland cells, that will lead to production of the breast milk. So here I will straight away get full 4 marks for mentioning the key points. Okay, so here is the layout of how my answer will look like. I have given 2 last points options. So first I have mentioned HPRL as a signaling molecule. Then I say that HPRL acts on the target cells. Here in near the target cell, I can actually write the mammary cells are the target cells. And they are the target cells because they have PRLR. If they don't have this, then HPRL won't recognize them. So then I say that PRLR is my surface membrane receptor. And then I say that PRLR and HPRL will complementarily bind, leading to specific response. And I state the response over here. I don't just give a general statement. I specify the response over here is mammary gland cell will produce milk. Or the fourth point could also look like complementary binding of the HPRL and PRLR leads to activation of many enzymes that will produce the secondary messenger. Secondary messenger is CAMP, C-A-M-P, cyclic AMP. That will lead to a cascade of reaction which will activate more enzymes in the cells, leading to milk production in the mammary cells. So I have covered all my points and I should be getting 4 marks over here. So now that you saw one example, remember the key points. They have to be there in your answer. And now it is your turn to practice.